2029, the hovercraft, many streamed numerous of transport, have been developed in our century. The stranger of them being perhaps the hovercraft. In 1953, a former electronics engineer in his 50s, Christopher Cacareo, who had turned to building on the Norfolk Broad, suggested an idea on which he had been working for many years to the British government and industrial circles. It was the idea of supporting a craft on a pad or cushion of low pressure air, ringed with a curtain of high pressure air. Ever since, people have had difficulty in deciding whether the craft should be ranged among ships, planes, or land vehicles, for it is something in between a boat and an aircraft. As a shipbuilder, Cacareo was trying to find a solution to the problem of the wind resistance, which with a good deal of surface ship's power and limits its speed. His answer was to lift the vessel off the water by making it ride on a cushion of air. No more than 1 or 2 feet thick. This is done by a great number of ring-shaped air jets on the bottom of the craft. It flies, therefore, but it goes far higher. Its action depends on the surface, water or ground, over which it arrives. The first test on solid caused the sensation. The hovercraft traveled first over the water, then mounted the beach, climbed up the dunes, and sat on our boat. Later it crossed the channel, riding smoothly over the waves, which presented no since that time, various types of hovercraft have appeared and taken up regular service. The hovercraft is particularly useful in large areas with poor communication, such as Africa or Australia. It can become a flying fruit bowl carrying bananas from the plantations to the ports. Giant hovercraft liners could span the Atlantic. The highway of the future may well be the hovercraft train. Riding on its air cushion over a single rail. Which it never touches and speeds up to 300 miles per hour. The possibilities appear unlimited.